Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Daytona International Speedway for the GoPro Be a Hero Duel here at Daytona for duel number one. Should be a fun race to watch, as we were supposed to go racing, what, 2-3 days ago, but rained out the last 2 days and the rain just didn't stop coming. But we're seeing much clearer skies now for today's race, and hopefully we can get all three races in, which includes both duels and the truck race. Zachary Fitzwater Sr. for Fitzwater Australian is on your front row, along with Ramian Fisher in the 5 for Horizon Incorporated. As we have Ford and Chevy starting up front. Behind these guys, we have Gus Powell, the rookie, in the 78. He's starting third for Longhorn Racing. Along next to him, Trevor Collins, another rookie, starts fourth for Motorcraft Racing. Behind these guys, we have Jeff Bright in the 24 for Horizon Motorsports, and Charnard in the 42 for Autism Speaks Racing. And behind these guys, we have Nick Smith, who was so ready to go in that clash, but ended up getting taken out after an early wreck, and he's hoping for some luck here his way today. Next to him, as Dodge returns to Cup Series competition, Tommy McQueen, rookie, starts 8th for T-Bone Racing in that Mopar Dodge. And we have Nathan Ormond for Autism Speaks Racing. Hopefully I'm saying that last name right. Let me know if I'm not. Sam Edoskin in the 9, who won this race last year, or not this race, but the Coke Zero 400. He was the last major winner here at Daytona, besides Joe Jefferson in the duel. Eric Monaco, or not the duel, the clash. Eric Monaco starts alongside Malik Nevins in the 10. Nevins returned to Cup Series competition as well. Shane Wensloff in the 7. He starts 13th for Hylakitha Racing Enterprises, and next to him, Max Anderson in the 20. Toyota Care, Toyota for Fallout Racing, as Anderson moving from the 2 to the 20 and also switching manufacturers. Bubba Jones, who's making a one-off start, or trying to make a one-off start for the Daytona 500, he starts in the 99. And Alexander Rowe in the 11, moving from the 31 team to the 11 for this season. Jack Halleck now, the 13, earlier, before they went on the starting grid, something was amiss inside the car, inside the cockpit itself. Not sure what was going on. Had something to do with the steering wheel of the car. And so we'll be keeping an eye on the 13 throughout the race. Tyler Markell in the 38, next alongside Dylan Ebrahimian in the 2, as Ebrahimian continuing to stay with Ford as he drove the 2 last season. Then on the final row, we have the 44 of Nicholas Wade, another rookie for Autism Speaks Racing. So there's your starting lineup for today's race, as this is duel number one. 20 laps, 21 drivers in pit stop should occur throughout today's race. That's about all the info we have. Let's take you down trackside for the commands. There we go, the most beautiful sound in motorsports. The engines have been fired here as drivers finally getting ready to go. And for a lot of drivers, this is their first time on the track, period. We didn't even have any practice or qualifying sessions or any of that. Some drivers, this is their absolute first time on the track this season. Some drivers, including Gus Powell in the 78, and Zachary Fitzwater Sr., who finished 18th in the clash, was involved in that wreck. And didn't get much time on the track, actually, so it's going to be interesting to see how well Fitzwater do here, as Fisher is going to start to his outside. Fisher had a great run in the clash as he finished 3rd. So yeah, some guys that have not been on the track yet, and we're definitely going to keep an eye on this 13. Hopefully their steering issue goes away. So they didn't want to risk not being able to start the 500. So we'll see what happens. Bubba Jones, another driver who needs to finish better than the other two drivers that are attempting the 500, including Dylan Young and Alex Perry in the 02, which both will be in duel number 2. So only one of those three drivers can make the 500, and it's the highest finisher of both. And whoever If one of them wins their duel, they'll be automatically locked into Sunday's race. Hopefully it can be Sunday. So, Zachary Fitzwater, Remy and Fisher, two really good friends starting on the front row. And a lot of things we're going to be seeing today that we saw in Clash is manufacturers working together. Dodge is the lone manufacturer for this race. As the pace cars pull down pit road, the crowd is going wild here. And the green flag is out as duel number one is underway. Fitzwater with the early lead, already three wide, now in the corner number one. Jeff Bright wasting no time as he's alongside Gus Powell for second. Another thing we're going to be seeing a lot today is aggressive locking. We saw it in the Clash, and there you see Fitzwater. As he's trying to bring that inside line of Jeff Bright and others with him. And already Chevy hooking up. Yeah, the two Chevys right there, Jeff Bright and Sean Ard, 42 and 24. Fitzwater with the lead. He's going to go up. The 42 is going to go way up there too. And he's going to come back down and block. That's the blocking I was talking about. As lap number one goes to the 34 of Zachary Fitzwater Sr. And a car going around in the backfield. That's the 20 of Max Anderson. And it looks like he's going to keep it off the wall. And the caution flag is going to be out. And the 24, or not the 24, the 4 of Nick Smith with the lead. And yes, I had to actually call the caution for myself because it didn't come out, obviously. So that's why they came back on the track so fast. But leading at the line, it's going to be the 4 of Nick Smith. Followed by Jeff Bright in the 24. The caution flag flies here on lap number 1 of duel 1. I don't think the 20 of Anderson suffered any damage whatsoever. He should still be good as we're going to try and get a replay and see what happened. And it looks like there may have been four wide. Either that or Nevins came down in front of the 20 and 20 kind of went over and came across the nose of the 13 of Halleck right there. And he was heading straight for that safer barrier. Had he got turned sooner, he probably would have hit that white wall up there. Or not the safer barrier, the tire barriers, that is. He came really close to doing. Let's see. Yeah, right there. They were four wide exiting the tri-oval, and that wasn't going to work at all. And I really don't know who to blame right there. Not sure if Nevins came over and kind of forced a four-wide situation, or not really sure what happened. Maybe Anderson just came from underneath or came from behind Nevins onto the 13 and didn't see the 13 there. The spotter should have known better than that. Riding on board Max Anderson here.
Nice patience.
Yeah, Nevins definitely came down too, but it's really kind of hard to tell who to blame. But good news is that Anderson didn't suffer any damage as he should still be able to continue. We're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll be back. Nick Smith, the leader. Welcome back to NORLA on Fox here at the Daytona International Speedway. You are watching duel number one. As we just had our first caution of the day on lap number one, Anderson going for a wild spin out of the tri-oval, but he is fine and should still be able to be up to speed. Nick Smith in the four-year leader, Jeff Bright, Nathan Ormond, Gus Powell, and Trevor Collins, your top five. As we get set to try and go green one more time here. And there goes the pace car down pit road, the crowd back on its feet, as Smith is going to lead the field back to the green flag. Ormond trying to go to the outside. No one really went with him there. And there he goes back now down to the inside as he's going to have the 78 maybe try and draft up to him here. And with raw speed, Nathan Ormond in the one going for the lead. The Chevy's going to go with him of the 24 of Jeff Bright. And that's the manufacturer thing I was talking about. And there goes Jeff Bright's teammate Samet Oskin along with Ramian Fisher. They're all down there to the inside. And Nathan Ormond trying to lead his first laps here in the Cup Series. Well, Jeff Bright let him have it. Ormond goes high. Jeff Bright to the inside. Ormond with the block, and he's going to do it as Nathan Ormond is going to lead lap number one. Or not number one. He'll lead his first lap here in duel number one. The 38 of Tyler Markell complaining about his car, as we're going to listen in to the 38 of Markell here, who looks like he has some damage.
A lot of left front body, a lot of left front fender. You're going to have to get the hood down.
Some hood damage.
Get that taped off. Get that left front clearance.
Copy that. He definitely has some hood damage to the car. They're going to probably need to go in and get that fixed, because that's definitely going to affect the handling and the aero of the car. There's a 99 of Jones. And 11 cars going in as well. Alexander Rowe. He's going to make his way down pit road for what seems to be an unscheduled pit stop for the 11. Now the field is kind of split up just a little bit. A couple of guys hanging around in the back. But up here, they're getting pretty racy as Fisher is out front. And I guess you could say his half-teammate Samet Oskin is behind him, as Fisher's for Horizon Incorporated. 7 career wins. And won a championship back in season 2. Went winless last season, and he's hoping to turn it around as the Dodge of Tommy McQueen in the 33 lines up behind Fisher. 79 is also there. It's coming around a lead this time by Ramien Fisher in the 5. He's out front. We got the Toyota right there, the lone Toyota. In the 79, or Jeff McReynolds. Fisher with a big line of cars with him on the outside right there. The inside is not really shaped up too well. And Nathan Ormond once again going back for the lead. Markell looks like he went down pit road and tried to get that damage fixed up as much as possible. And he's going to try to blend in with this pack here. This could be real dangerous, but you don't want to go down into the access road. In the corners, he goes right up in front of the 24 of Jeff Bright and Eric Monaco. He's going to hold up those guys, and now the pack is even more separated than before. And out front, Jeff McReynolds in a 79, as he's gonna come around and lead this time by. McQueen behind him, Fisher to the inside, but doesn't really have any drafting help. McQueen's gonna go down there and try to carry that 5 around the 79 of McReynolds. And there's the 11 they're catching, as Max Anderson looks like he's about to go a lap down. Or not Max Anderson, Alexander Rowe. That inside line really shaped up right there. Nick Smith trying to go with the 11, not sure why. Maybe the 11's a bit slower, I think that's what it was. As Nick Smith now to the outside of the 11, but here comes the 1 once again. Gonna come around this time. McQueen Dodge is gonna come around and lead their first lap in a long time here in the Cup Series, as McQueen at the line. Kinda weird saying that, considering reminds me of Lightning McQueen. There's a 13 we've been talking about, and he has been complaining about the car even more. That's Jack Halleck in the 13, as we're going to listen in to the number 13 Turtle Beach crew here.
The air pressure build is just making this car horrible.
Or Turtle Glue.
Police is shit, man, going on the exit loop.
Exit's
really
loose.
Yes, sir, it's right there, yes.
Hearing something about the car being extremely tight. Tight in the corners, and remember, that's the thing we were talking about, is he seems to be okay for now, but still we're going to keep an eye on that 13 throughout the race. As out front is Jeff McReynolds in the 79, the rookie. Looks like he led that time by. Ormond once again, that one car is looking really fast here, as he's going to have help from Samet Oskin, another Chevrolet. Down to the inside right there. 79 of McReynolds with a big run on the outside. Looks like he's going to try and come down and clear the one car from Nathan right there. 11 stuck in the middle. He's just trying to get out front and hope for a quick caution and get his lap back. And remember, the winner of this race will be declared the pole sitter for the Daytona 500. And then the winner of Duel 2 will start on the outside front row. This race is going to set the inside row. And duel number 2 is going to set the outside row. McReynolds once again pouncing at that lead. Fitzwater kind of hanging at the back of this pack right now, along with Trevor Collins. There are a bunch of cars on that inside line right there, led by McReynolds. closest Toyota, Mitt Reynolds, is a 7 of Shane Wensloff right there in that Pepsi Toyota. Nathan Normal now down to the inside. Everyone's going to follow. And the lone Dodge out there left on the outside to dry. Don't forget the ProCore IndyCar Series will be live from Kentucky, which will be the next race for the IndyCar Series, as those open wheel drivers head to their first oval all of the season. At Kentucky, should be a fun race to watch, as Roman's going to come around and lead that time by. Here comes a 7 now down to the inside, 3 wide for the lead. Christian in the middle right there, Eric Monaco in the 3, made his way back up here to the front, and he's going to dive it down. 3 wide is 4 wide almost. Nevins need to back out of there, and that's exactly what he's going to do. Good call by Nevins to back out of that one right there. So that could have been a crash. Well, a couple of drivers hanging in the back. That's the 21, the 24, the 2. We just had a big block right there by the 7 car on the inside. 4 drivers on the inside, 1 car in the middle right there, and that's Nevins, as he's going to fall back. 7, Sam Adoskin with a big run on the outside. He's going to have help from Nathan Ormond in the 1, and he's going to lead that time by. He's getting ready to be that point of the race where you're going to have to find someone to work with. And the outside line can get a run, as we saw it in the clash and we've seen it here. It's all about a matter of how many people is up there and who's pushing you, really. Monaco to the middle and back down to the inside. And a reason you see a lot of the drivers on the backstretch, they go up to the middle or to the outside and then they sweep back down to the inside. This is so that they can bring whoever is on the outside and the middle line closer to them with the draft, and then, you know, go down and block the inside line. That way, no one on the outside can really make a pass, and that keeps the leader in the lead, if that makes sense. There's a 99 right there with Sean Ard in a 42. Those guys hanging in the back. Not that Ron Jones needed right now, is he's going to need a miracle to get up here. There's a 13. Looks like their issue is been solved. They're still kind of hanging at the back of this lead pack right here. Lone Dodge once again in the middle. Nick Smith on the inside. Fisher behind him. And Jeff McReynolds in the 79 behind those two. Monaco and Oskin on the outside. They're going to fall back here. And drivers coming down pit road, led by the 33 of Tommy McQueen. And the first round of pit stops are here. And it should be the last round, actually. Couple drivers going down pit road, and I guess it's whoever comes off first, maybe in the catbird seat here, is Nick Smith. He's going to stay out alongside or along with Eric Monaco in the 3. And these guys are going to have to come in this time by, because no one can make it all the way on fuel. Halleck right now currently running in the 13th position. He's going to have drafting help from the 34th, Zachary Fitzwater Sr., who started up front today. Eric Monaco making sure he sticks with the 4, because when you come out of pit road, you're going to need drafting partners. Else whoever does have a drafting partner will catch up to you now. Here they come for their round of pit stops. There's 11 of Alexander Rowe. He's going to stay out and try to get that lap back. And I don't know if a caution is going to help him at this point. There's Fisher. These guys are already off pit road from their services. And Fisher looks like he's going to have the 7 for a drafting partner. And the 33, the Dodge, he's out there by himself. Doesn't really have anyone around him. And Fisher and Wensloff is going to be able to catch up to him quite quickly here. Tommy McQueen, Ulysses Nelson will be in duel number 2. So he's lone Dodge out there. There's Nick Smith on the access road coming out of the pits. He too is by himself. That's not good at all either for Nick Smith, as we're going to see where the 33 is. There he is, flying out of 2. And Fisher and Wensloff, they're hooked up and they're trying to draft up to these guys now. When will the 33 catch the 4? Because now both drivers are by themselves, so it's all about horsepower here. And Nick Smith is not even fully up to speed yet, so I believe the 33 will catch up to him. These guys flying out of turn 4. There's a 33 with a huge run right there on Nick Smith. Smith is going to lead this time by. The 33 is caught him, and they're now both in the draft. Fisher and Halleck continuing to work together, trying to catch these guys up here. Or not Halleck, Wenzoff. I keep saying Halleck. Now side by side for the lead. They know this is go time, and that right there is going to allow the 7 and the 5 to catch these guys in a hurry here. And look at the huge run the 7 of Wenzloff gets, along with Fisher. Smith's going to try to go down there and block. Fisher's not having it. Fisher not going underneath Nick Smith for third. There's a 33 still out front with the Toyota behind him here. Is out of turn 4. Here we go. Big block right there by the 33. And at the line, white flag, one to go, presented to you by Target. Here comes a 7 of Wenzloff down to the inside. As now Toyota is hooked up. Dodge, Chevy, and Ford by themselves, so this did not work in their favor as the Toyota team is hooking up right here. Wenzloff and Nick Reynolds. Eric Monaco, he's back there, but I don't think he's going to be able to catch these guys. Man, what a well-planned strategy by the Toyotas. As into the final corner, will the 79 make the move? As out of 4, this is for the Daytona 500 pole to the outside, the 79 to the inside. He blocks him, and at the line, they're not going to pass him. That is going to be Shane Wenzloff at the line. And a big win right there, and a big congratulations to Shane Wenzloff, the rookie, on capturing the win. And he will start on the pole for the Great American Race. Man, that was a big and risky block that he threw on McReynolds right there, but great driving by the rookie nonetheless. And those two Toyotas hooking up is probably what got him the win. Is the other manufacturers, Ford, Chevy, and then Dodge, they were not coordinated at all. But congratulations to Shane Wenzloff on getting the win. He is your Season 16 Daytona 500 pole sitter with that win. And now, hopefully we can get the dual number 2 drivers out as well. And I say that because I have yet to edit the race. Probably won't put as much effort into editing duel number 2. Is congratulations to Shane Wenzloff on the win here, burning it down for the crowd. And thank you guys for watching, as hopefully we can see you in duel number 2. And until then, thank you guys for watching.